And then my plan, which remember when I said, oh, best route ever? Remember that? Best route ever?
Nope. I have absolutely no recollection of what you're talking about.
Well, if this goes to Fendrana, then it's best route ever.
Why hasn't somebody created a goddamn Anadex yet?
Hey, look at that. It goes to Fendrana.
Put it together. Put it together.
And sorry, what did you say, World? I didn't even hear the
Anadex.
Word.
Anadex.
Nope.
Da 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 da.
Oh.
Ba, da 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 da.
Pokédex for Metroid?
No, Anadex, as in like a real life dex for animals. So you could point it at an animal and it would be like.
Oh.
Galiensica Disforma or whatever the fuck. I don't fucking know.
Caribou are weakness to our.
Wolves,
the encroachment of mankind, and global warming.
Like, straight, all it has to do is have like a little camera. A fucking index of like all the currently discovered
with all
animals.
All the animals have to be looking absolutely miserable in the Pokedex.
Miserable.
Especially the ones that are like in dire situations of like extinction. They have to look absolutely miserable.
Like, seriously, how cool would that be if you could just walk out into nature and you had this little thing? It was like the size of a smartphone. And sure, it might fold open or whatever for durability purposes. But yeah. And then you just point it at a fucking animal and it's just like elk.
Because this is fucking Pokemon.
But dude, think of like that would be awesome for anybody, dude. I bet a lot of people would like that.
Yeah, I suppose.
And how would the technology itself work? Just picture matching?
It would have to have sort of like a reference thing, and it would have to match that with the pictures and stuff. I'm not sure, obviously, exactly how it would work.
Hey, remember when this was a boss?
Now it's just a boss.
Actually, it's just a thing in this room that we're never gonna interact with.
But is that the same thing you fought for the weight beam?
Yeah.
Shugoth, yeah. Wow.
Drink.
Oh, jeez. I almost rolled too far.
And why isn't there an organization seeking to stockpile extremely rare, almost extinct animals yet, and then possibly exploit them or sell them for lots of money?
You mean zoos?
No, I meant Team Rocket.
Oh, Team Rocket. Yeah.
Is that what their actual business plan is?
That is the business. Straight up, kidnap and stockpile rare creatures, aka Pokemon. But in reality, be animals.
Hey.
And then either exploit them or sell them.
Who likes having maximum health?
I mean, I don't know, but like a mission statement for Team Rocket. But yeah, it's about the same thing.
Whoa, that door didn't like opening. Come on, I can make that shot. I made that shot.
That face when in 20 years, nobody knows what Pokemon is, but we'll be fucking like...
No, Pokemon will be around.
Okay, that face when in 40 years, technology has reached a height and nobody knows what Pokemon is.
Wait, hold on, did you just take the amount of years?
Yes, I corrected them.
Yeah.
I don't know if that was my point.
Anyway, having society turn out similar to Pokemon and then being like, hey, wait a minute, this is all like shit that was fucking in this game. And then everybody's like, yeah, shut up, old man. And then there really is some fucking group that's like stealing animals and shit, like anti-environmentalists. And there's people that are trained in animals because now they've got nano shit that allows you
and
to fucking...
actually call themselves Team Rocket.
Whoa, whoa,
no, they don't actually call themselves Team Rocket.
Did anybody see that?
Yes, I know. He's like burned, right?
No, he teleported. I hit him and then he teleported. Wait, whoa, is he...
Yeah, he died. He died.
Yeah,
don't think I like using the plasma beam on these guys. I don't think I like that.
Bunch of fucking jerk offs in black start walking around and taking goddamn animals.
You can't explore this cave because man.
Yeah, you can't explore this cave because we're here. Well, what if I punch you in the face?
Why would you do that?
Yeah, that's illegal. That's illegal. Seriously though, why did nobody ever punch anybody in the face in Pokemon?
Casca fuck, bro.
No, you can't do this. You can't do this.
I'm always scared that thing's gonna like hit the grapple.
Me and
thing.
My girlfriend are out here catching some bug Pokemon. Battle. Like, what? Go back to your girlfriend, buddy. Bug catcher Dean.
Drink.
Bug catcher Jane.
So, Mumph, all that's left in this game then is missile expansions and artifacts, right? You've got all the
I think there's a power bomb expansion I'm missing still.
Okay. How many power bombs are you at right now?
7, I think.
Okay.
Which way did I come from? I came from that way, so I want to go to the door to my right. Which is this door? Yeah.
Hey, Goofs.
It's time for this.
Oh, it's ghost busting time? Yeah.
Won't even get off the ground and won't get his fucking salvo off.
They do crash into you, and at least in later Metroid Prime games, it totally does damage.
Because I was going to say, that was kind of like wimpy and pathetic looking.
Yeah, I think it does like 15, 20 damage.
In later games, it starts to get more significant, I think.
I hope so.
It should, man. This is like big old fucking...
Whoa! Jeez!
Especially after you've got so much, like, you have shit tons of health.
Yeah.
Goddamn, 1,400 health.
Yeah, but I guess that, remember, the designers of the game can't necessarily count on you having a shit ton of health.
I suppose.
Okay, none of these are invisible. I know there's a reason I'm here. Yeah, that's where.
Hey, world. If you had to choose between playing yellow version for the rest of your life or silver, what would you pick?
Silver.
Yeah. Right on.
Silver has essentially the content of yellow in it.
Pretty much. It's full color. I really like straight up, dude. I played the original one, but I can actually remember the because I got the originals for Christmas with my brother, and I got yellow and red, or I got red and he got blue and yellow, and then the Christmas that silver and gold came in, like, because I had read the magazine, the Nintendo Power, and it talked about the little opening about your rival and all that shit and stuff. Okay. And I got so hyped, dude. I seriously remember playing the opening of silver and just absolutely being fucking in love. Like, it was just like, there was the day and night cycle, full color.
There's the last power bomb.
The story is a bit better, I personally feel like, last in silver. Hype. It was just like such a fantastic, like, that is Pokemon to me, man. The silver and gold era, like, that is what I guess I would call, funnily enough, the golden era of Pokemon.
I see what you did there. I'll drink to that, sir.
Taking the lowest door in this room.
Yeah. Like your rival, man. I like your rival in silver better. Because he's straight up, he's a fucking malignant son of a bitch. Yeah, he's straight up just like, I stole this shit. And then he's just like, don't get in my fucking way, or otherwise I'm going to fuck you up.
Yeah,
and then he pieces off. He's not like, I'm going to be the best. He's just like, dude, don't get in my fucking way right now.
I definitely recall him dropping the F-bomb like 5 times during the game.
Oh, yeah, definitely. No, that was the thing. It was... It got Peggy 15, okay?
Peggy 15.
Even though Peggy didn't exist back then.
Peggy 18.
Peggy 18. Peggy 14. Peggy, fuck you if you can't handle this game.
Wait, I came in here for an expansion, but I'm actually pretty sure there's nothing in here.
Parental Entertainment Guidance Index.
But what I do know is that there is one over here.
So you're just wrapping up missing things in this area, Mo?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, that guy's cooling system failed.
Yeah, I think it might have...
Booyah!
I like how your arm looks. Yeah, you can see it's like all red and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I'm short on this.
Is that last year Balticus?
No, there's one more. Did you want it?
No, I just want to see how you're going.
I'm going deep. How many beers are you in, two?
I'm only 3 in. What are you?
I think I've had 4 of yours.
You've had 4 of those and the 2 Balticas?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Fuck. fucking Striker over here.
Dude, fucking, I told you.
Striking the fucking bears.
I was drinking for every fucking door month was going through.
Have we had any donations in a while?
That's good. Yeah, let's take a look. Nope, none since Golden Dawn.
Really?
Yep, really, really.
How about questions?
Really? I enjoyed question period, though. Question period was fun. Yeah, if you guys have any questions in the chat, feel free to ask them. I'm keeping an eye on chat. Mump is trying to do what he can, obviously, but obviously trying to get through the game, of course. Yes, GM92. Where is Ted Donation, bro? Ted Donation, bro.
Ted Donation. It's all about the Ted Donation.
How drunk are you guys? Well, I don't think World or Mump. Well, certainly Mump isn't drunk. World might be a little bit on the buzz end.
Yeah, I'm not. I'm not drinking.
I'm starting to see some haze.
Okay.
Some Billy Mays haze.
Let's say that
Mays
haze.
That Mays haze. Yeah.
Remember when I said we weren't going to go back into the research facility?
We're going back in the research
facility. We're now going there, and it's probably still super dark.
Are any of you guys fans of Souls series games? Either Dark Souls or Bloodborne?
I really enjoyed Dark Souls 2. Bloodborne just didn't grab me like Dark Souls 2 did.
Zeritas? I don't know if you know, but we did a Dark Souls 2 marathon quite a while ago where I was
I was gonna say we played a lot of that game, but we actually did not play a lot of that game.
I certainly enjoyed that game quite a bit.
We all played a lot of that game on our own time.
Yeah, and we did a few streams and stuff like that here and there. How long was that marathon? Did we do 12?
It was like 8 or 12.
Okay. Yeah. I can't remember how far we got. I don't think we got anywhere like near as far as like the gutter or anything like that.
Oh no. No. We just like we barely got to Hyde's Tower.
No, we must have gotten farther than that.
It's surprisingly not that really? Far. Yeah.
Wow.
We spent a lot. You were very cautious.
Yeah. Yeah, I was. Yeah.
So it was all fucking Striker's fault.
Wow.
Well, it was really good play. It's just we didn't like get very far.
admin dip dip. I never played Hyrule Warriors. I was kind of like skeptical about it until I heard about somebody else I was talking to on the chat, and they had recommended it, and I looked into it a little bit more. It seemed kind of cool. I still haven't played it. I don't intend on playing it anytime soon. I don't think any of these guys.
I did get this expansion, right? Yeah, I don't see it.
Yeah, you got it.
What's SAO abridged? Mom, do you know what that is?
Nope.
Okay. Max missiles is 250?
In this game, yep. I believe in 2 and 3 it's 255.
Okay.
Which I believe is close to, is like the original.
Mom, do you have a favorite anime?
I mean, do I have a favorite, or do I? What do I think is best? I guess I'll answer the question. Favorite? I don't know. I really liked Code Geass.
I just gotta throw this out there. Anybody in the chat want to throw down a shout out for Inuyasha?
Well, and I mean, like the answer of best anime is Attack on Titan. But favorite? I don't know. Death Note was really good. But Code Geass stuck with me. Another one of my favorites is called Noeen. I don't know if anybody in the chat has watched Noeen, let me know, because I'd love to, like, it's not super common.
Yeah, I really like Death Note. I certainly like Attack on Titan. It's really good anime. I think last year I got into watching a little bit of classic anime, and so I'd watched, obviously, Cowboy Bebop, and then I got into a series called Trigun. And I really like them. So I think if I had to pick, I would probably go with one of those two again. Even though the series runs relatively short compared to other anime series. I really enjoyed the seriousness of Cowboy Bebop, and the even though the story was kind of slow to come up on Trigun, I really appreciated the style and the music as well. That's what really kind of gets me with TV shows or even video games or series, is the soundtrack. I'm sure Mempf can appreciate that as well.
Yeah, soundtracks.
Yeah, are soundtracks. Huge. Soundtracks are.
That's why it's number one reason why I think Halo 4 is a bad game.
Yeah.
Because I don't know any piece of music from that. Like, it's not Halo. That game is not Halo. Like, from the way it feels kind of point of view. Wait, how do I get out of here? Do I go out a different way?
Did any of you guys watch Full Metal Alchemist?
Yeah, we've all watched Full Metal Alchemist. Oh, wait, man, I don't know about World. Have you?
Only Springer? A little bit.
Did you watch Brotherhood Mempf?
I've seen them both. Yeah, I've seen both.
Okay, yeah, I saw both as well. I enjoyed them. They're good.
Yeah, but I wouldn't say one's better than the other. Brotherhood's probably better, but I'd say you've got to watch them both.
Yeah.
I'd say watch them both, but the really tough question is which do you watch first? If you're introducing someone to the series for the first time.
See, I didn't realize that the Brotherhood series existed, so I'd watch the other one first before. And then
after Brotherhood it was already out?
Yeah. So I had watched that other one first, and then Strife came up to me, and he was like, hey, like, this other one exists. And I was like, oh, really? And he was like, yeah, it's pretty good. So that's why I got into that.
So we're just, since we were halfway through this space pirate base anyway, we're just going to go through all the way to the other side. Have I seen Magus XLR? No, I've not. It's space pirates. I'm just so uninterested with fighting, like, things I don't have to fight anymore.
Worst Pokemon game, Black and White.
I'm not qualified to talk about that. I haven't played enough of the later ones. That was fun.
The world... Do you have a war face?
Yeah.
Yeah? What's your war face look like?
It's pretty good.
It's pretty good. I don't want to see good and when it, like, for your war face. I want to see terrifying. I want to see some motherfucker who's going to stand by my back. Stand by that parapet and take those bullets for me.
That's the trick of the war face is you don't have to look scary. You just got to look like you're going to get shit done.
Ooh. That's my boy world.
Whoa! That guy exploded. Watch the stream. Watch the stream.
Okay, watching stream.
And here.
Sorry, I'm watching it too.
Okay, never mind.
I'm just watching. Yeah.
Oh, that guy. That's the guy. There you go.
Christopher Toy has subscribed.
Yeah.
I'm as much as I love this game, I am so starting to be at the end of this run.
Yeah.
This room has gotten really hot again. Okay. I will follow the... Okay. That seems like a fair fight to me. They don't even show up. They just die. Another one, huh? Hey, remember this music? It's been a while. Yeah, it really has been a long time since we've been in Pendrana. Despite there being a spider ball track in here, I'm pretty sure it's just a shortcut to get back up and nothing more. See, here's where we're starting to get into really risky territory, where anything that I don't find in the next 5 minutes to 5-10 minutes might take a little while longer. And that might be where, if we haven't met the donation incentive, where we call trying to stop trying to get 100% of the items.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, I still need... How many more artifacts do I need? Two or one?
What about all those fucking missile expansions in Fendrana here that need the plasma beam?
Yeah. No, don't worry. I'm just starting to think, like, where's the other two artifacts? I haven't gotten the one at the temple.
Yep.
So I only need to find one artifact. Which I know exactly where it is. No, I know exactly where it is. Yeah, we're totally good.
You're only one artifact short?
I'm two, but one of them is at the artifact temple.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they give you one for free. Oh, I guess I didn't have all the power bombs. Oh, geez, that's lagging now. Okay, we're good. It's to stop lagging. By the way, that's a full-size Shigoth in this area. I'm curious about this, though.
Nice.
That's why it's not a boss anymore. Oh, there's actually a shit ton of things to do in this room. Sorry, there's two rooms that I'm thinking of. I got the thing that was in here. And isn't there like an ice thing around a corner somewhere? Or is that a different room?
It's the next room.
So this room's clear?
Yeah, I think so.
Mom, have you ever watched Ghost in the Shell?
A little bit. Like one episode. Two episodes maybe. Yeah.
I thought Ghost in the Shell was a movie.
That's both.
Yeah, there are movies. Yeah. They're pretty good. First couple movies are pretty good.
Isn't that about cybernetic world?
Yep. Sort of. Mostly. I watched that series when...
Sorry, Shigoth, you did not see this coming.
When Bisk and I were traveling Europe, that was one of the anime series we were getting into. I certainly enjoyed it, and I actually hadn't seen any of the movies until I got back to Canada after my travels. And I really enjoyed it. It was really good.
You got that one missile expansion down there?
Yep.
What's H.P.A.W.'s opinion on Kingdom Hearts?
Well, we all fucking hate it.
Can someone just link them to the amount of marathons and the videos I've done in the past of Kingdom Hearts?
You know what? Like,
yeah.
Can I, let me try and answer that a different question. Does anybody want to do a Kingdom Hearts 2 marathon, like, immediately following this?
No.
All right. Well, I'm the only one then.
Was it 1.5? We stopped.
Oh God, you're right. No, it's 1.5. Oh, I didn't finish 1.5. I know, it's the worst.
It was 1.5 HD remix, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Shadow Heart series. You guys ever heard of that?
Nope.
Neither have I.
I'm also getting dangerously close to running out of ideas for where missile expansions are.
Yeah?
Have you gone up that vertical tower? And gotten the artifact?
Sorry, I did just remember where a couple of them are. So we might be okay still.
Like this room, for instance.
Mm-hmm.
This room has at least two, if not three.
It's this one. I'm still missing five, though, right? Yeah. That's more than I'm, like, thinking I can account for.
To my knowledge, Mumph owns three amiibos?
I own one.
One.
Well, I mean, the Yoshi's a gift, but no one's gonna come and get it at this point, so...
Oh.
I guess I own two.
But I know you've got your Samus one.
Yeah, that's the one.
And it's, what, level 50 for Smash?
That's max level, so yeah.
Right on. And the other one is
doesn't take very long, though.
I think you destroy that stone right there, eh?
Where?
That thing, over to your right. That little tunnel over there. That, over there, yeah.
Here?
Jump across, and then on the left-hand side. Don't you destroy that fucking block? Isn't there something in the middle of that?
Whatever you're thinking of, I did already. I think. But I do know where... another one is. I I never got this one.
Oh, how the fuck? I remember seeing that when I came here.
Oh, I gotta do this jump again, huh? Oh, that's easy now.
How the hell do you get there?
Spider.
Spider?
Spider.
Spider starting from here.
Spider ball.
You managed to stay awake all night through Grandma's stories.
Have a heart piece.
Straight up.
What was that mask called?
The all-night mask.
All-night mask, yeah.
The all-night mask. Just so you can fucking stay through that old bag's fucking story.
I think it was stories for all three nights.
The game's telling me to go, the game's telling me to go finish it now.
Yes. Oh, that's the artifact temple.
Yep.
But it would only tell you to go there if you had all 12 artifacts.
No, it wouldn't.
Oh, really?
It's just because there it gives you hints on where to find the other artifacts.
Oh, yes. You scan the thing and the things and they tell you where the things are.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We give you a clue. It gives you like a hint on what room it is and maybe a little bit of a help.
And this room has the last artifact.
Yep.
As well as the missile expansion.
Does it?
I think so.
Oh, I would have already gotten that.
Yeah, you might have already gotten the missile.
But this. Oh, wait. No, wait. No, it doesn't have a missile.
This isn't the 12th artifact? This is the 11th one you have?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep. But the last one I'm required to collect at the moment. I'm really starting to get concerned about where these other expansions are, though. Because I don't know.
Well, you're only missing three.
No, I'm missing four, aren't I?
250, you said, is max?
Yeah.
Well, you're at 235 right now.
Am I? Oh, I might. I thought it was 230. Shit, that's really shitty. What do I miss?
Any ideas, world? You're certain you've gotten everything from the Chozo Ruins?
No, that's where I'm the least certain.
Oh. What about Magmar Caverns?
Oh, jeez.
Did you ever go back to the fucking Dynamo?
Oh yeah, Dynamo.
Yeah, I did.
Okay.
Yeah, I definitely did. I feel like it's gotta be... I must have missed something in more than one area. I think I missed, like, one thing maybe in a couple spots. But man, I'm really drawing a blank on where these other... where these last few are. Three, right?
You're missing three, yeah.
That's slightly worse than last time.
Well, I mean, that was about the same. Well, I mean, you had an idea where two were and you're missing one, so...
I always can get the energy tanks, and I can always get the power bomb expansion. Oh! Oh! Still haven't done that.
The one that's in one of these columns?
No, I got that.
Oh.
But, I gotta go to the Tallon Overworld, actually.
Okay, that's good. The energy's flowing.
There's at least... there's possibly two.
Mm-hmm. You mean at the top of that room with the grapple where you need the plasma and you never went back to?
Yeah, that's the one.
You can't see it right now, Mom, but World's got a hell of a fucking smirk on his face.
Good for him. It's 30 degrees in here, by the way.
30? Yeah, it's getting pretty hot out here, too.
It's not bad out here, though. I don't think it's 30 in here.
No, almost certainly.
Yeah, it's... You have the AC on here?
No.
Oh.
Of course, no.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you put it on for the second half.
No, I had it on while you were
shit.
Away.
Yeah, it must be fucking cooking in your room, eh? You're like thinking I'm sweating balls.
Is the chat? Does it have any ideas where the other one might be?
All right, chat. We need you for this.
Need you to fucking step up now here.
apparently you forgot to pick up the mining laser one.
No, that guy's full of shit. He totally... Wait, did you forget to pick it up? Did you blast it open and then not pick it up?
That would be pretty bum. That'd be pretty... That'd suck.
That's a long way back, bro.
It's not that far, actually. I've got shortcuts.
Okay, well, that was one of the suggestions, so...
If someone thinks that,
okay, so this other guy is saying it's 16C right now. Oh, sorry, it's right now. The two missile expansions have to be in the Tallon overworld.
Well, I know two of them are.
Okay. So at least one left.
Nice move.
And someone says it might be also be in the Phazon mines.
Yeah, I bet it's in the Phazon mines.
So two in the overworld, one in the Phazon mines?
Which two in the overworld?
I think there's two in the area I'm going for right now.
Did you get the one where you jump into the tree near the half pipe in the Chozo ruins?
Yep.
Yeah, you definitely got that one.
Yeah, I remember I was like, I haven't gotten a missile expansion in a while. Oh, there's one right in front of me.
Okay, looks like we're seeing more. The last one is in the mining laser in Phazon 9.
I did, like, I...
You definitely blasted it open.
I know. But I think I may have been so concerned with... Remember how I missed the laser almost?
Yeah, continuing on that you just forgot
about
it.
I feel like that's very possible. Although, again, why the fuck anybody in this chat let me proceed?
So far... Damn it, people. You like, fucking guys owe us some donations. Come on, cough it up. Cough it up. Smoke, spears.
Yeah, what do you got? Let's see it. Refresh.
Hold on, hold on.
Corey, Trevor, smoke.
Neosonic is onto something here. He's typically talking about something that's closer to where I am. So I'm inclined to...
Like I said, have you gone to... I was going to say you haven't gone to the top of this room.
Yeah, that's what I know I need to do right now.
So, Mump, you have a locale on two of them? You're just...
I'm pretty sure I have a locale on two.
Okay. So you're uncertain about one, kind of.
Well, we'll see. We'll see once I get out of this room. I know there's at least one thing fishy about this room, but I think there's more than one thing fishy about this room. Like, those invisible platforms, for one.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, there's an invisible wall. There's a wall that you can go through, and then there's also a plasma door thing at the top. Or maybe it's just a plasma door? I swore there was... Yeah.
Drink.
Oh, yeah.
Two to go.
Yeah, and I think one of them is literally, like... Is there a grapple here, or is it just a long jump?
It's a long jump.
Oh, shit, I can't even see where the edge of the platform was.
Oh, wow, they're right next to each other. One to go.
Okay, so...
Phazon Mines, here we come.
Do you think I should go for that?
I honestly think it's a reasonable, because I don't remember you grabbing that one. But I haven't remembered you grabbing some ones that you've obviously grabbed. I don't know, man. We haven't reached the 300-pound mark there, so...
Yeah, but you know what we have reached? Let's see. Give me a
World... Mike, Striker, is it time that I let World in on the secret? Or should I just not say anything until the very end? And when I say World, I mean everybody. It's a secret that only me and you know.
Yeah.
It's a secret to everyone.
Yeah, exactly. It's a secret to everyone.
So someone said Magmar and someone said Phazon Mines. There's a way to get to
what is the secret? You know, it.
Well,
but what?
You know, I said, we said, did we say 300 pounds?
Okay, let me ask, yeah, we did.
Oh, okay.
Let me ask this question. Does anybody in the chat say, is anyone in the chat saying I did in fact pick up the laser mine missile expansion? Because all I need is one person to say, well, one person can really fuck me up, but.
One person to stand on the opposite side.
Yeah, I just want to know if people are like, no, no, you totally got that.
The fate of this goddamn endeavor is in your hands, you fucking people.
You did not pick it up.
That's what I, the fact that I know, the fact that I can't say, oh no, I totally got that, is almost certain, make me certain.
Okay. Well, you know what? We didn't raise 300 pounds. We did, however...
I'm seeing way more people saying I did not get it than I did for people saying I did.
We did, however, raise 9,084.86 Indian rupees.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
That's a lot of rupees, man.
How much is the overall donation? How much are we at for the entire thing?
The entire thing, we are currently at 7,675.66 pounds.
That's pretty good.
Not bad, eh?
That's like a lot of dollars.
Yeah.
Man, I wish there was a way to use that grappled point to like make it across this room faster.
So you got last missile expansion, then artifact, then endgame. Right?
Yeah, the artifacts and the snow.
It's missile expansion and then endgame.
Oh, you've already got all the artifacts.
Yeah, for all intents and purposes.
You'll see what I'm talking about.
Okay.
Wow.
Wow.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes.
Okay.
Sometimes.
I'm going to start another beer. World, would you like one? Nick.
Well, I'm as bummed out as I am that I just totally forgot to pick it up, I'm glad I just spaced out for a moment rather than like, yeah, I just can't find where one is. Like, I'd much rather have a moment of like, oh, you've just forgot to go pick it up rather than, you have no fucking clue where it is, do you?
That face when?
To HPAW, can you type out the amount of money donated in chat, please?
Yeah, we'll get that done.
World, are you gonna get that done, or are you gonna get?
No, I'm not gonna get that done. But Striker's grabbing another brew.
Right, which automatically writes words.
Yeah. They would like you to publish the total donation amount in the chat, vis-a-vis text.
Total donation that we've raised during our segment. That's what they're asking.
Hey, what?
Hello.
Hey.
Check.
Hello. No.
Yeah. Oh, sorry. What? Yeah, the donation amount. It's in the chat.
Sorry, I was away grabbing a beer, so the chat's moved on.
The chat's moved on.
The chat has simply moved on. Okay, so, like I had said before, we're here to raise 9,000-something rubles, or 92 pounds and 69 pence.
The mining room's behind me, right? The mining room's pretty early on, right? Oh shit, this is the room where the pirates drop down, but I don't... maybe they don't drop down if you go this way. Interesting. Wait, but do they still die if you...
No.
Okay, interesting.
That would be funny as hell.
If they still died?
Yeah.
But they didn't attack you?
Maybe he won't notice. Ah!
Yeah, pretty much.
The righteous pain of burning to death.
I'm just gonna do it.
Yep, and no.
Whatever. They don't actually knock you off, so who cares?
Pretty much.
Just remember, kids, that's why we're in Scouts.
It's this room, Elite Research, right? There's Metroids in this room now, by the way.
This is fucking bullshit.
I'm curious about something here. I'm gonna specifically get attacked by a Metroid.
Then try and take it through the door.
Okay.
It just won't let you go through the door?
Yeah, it won't.
Damn.
I just wanted to see it just immediately explode.
Damn!
Okay. Well, it did just that.
What?
It exploded. I don't know why.
But it did.
Alright, so this is the room, right?
It reset.
Check it with your x-ray first, just real quick.
Oh, yep.
Yeah. Boom. Thank
you very much to everybody who did that. And a big fuck you to everybody who didn't tell me, like, go back.
Yeah, you fucking losers.
And to anybody who did, and these two guys in the room next to me didn't read it out, well, then it's their fault.
These two fucking guys.
Which two fucking guys are you talking about, dude?
He's talking about us or they girl?
I mean, like, I'll take responsibility for not, picking it up. But my explanation for why that happened.
That's a 250. I think
that's
because I was so concerned about blowing up this door.
Oh fuck, world, I'm drunk.
Oh fuck yeah, bud.
You know, you go out there and sometimes you just gotta punch through some doors and fight some bosses, and it's all about getting the expansions, and just gotta go out there and keep your stick on the ice and fight Prime.
Before you know it, you got 250 missiles and you're good to go.
Yeah, before you know it, you got yourself a playoff series. Back to you, Mump.
Back to me. Well, we got these Metroids crowding around. They definitely want to eat me. There's a lot of them right here.
That one just spawned.
Wow. Those kind of remind me of the things, the Sentinels in Halo world when you're doing the maw.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I'm trying to get you know what I'm talking about.
Oh,
yeah.
This is the wrong room.
Yeah.
Shit, I actually have to get into that room again with the Metroids.
Da 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 ba ba da
ba
ba da ba.
And enter the water room.
Ba ba da 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 ba 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 da 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 da.
Yeah, did you see that jump?
Yes.
Da 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 da.
Just barely make it.
Well, what the fuck was that? Indiana Jones.
Jones. That's why, because he did the grapple.
Oh, okay.
That's what I always made me think of as a kid, man. It's fucking grapple. I loved Indiana Jones as a kid.
Oh, motherfucker, that series was so good.
It was like fucking righteous.
Up until the series, the last movie, which you know the name.
Number three.
I didn't make it in a fourth movie yet.
Yeah, they did.
You don't really need to.
No, they didn't. They didn't make a fourth movie, that's true. Let's all agree on that.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, there was this like steaming pile of shit that came out, but
steaming pile of shit they called cinematography. But,
I don't think that was the next Indiana Jones movie.
Yeah, that was a Shia LaBeouf Transformers spinoff. Yeah.
Shia LaBeouf did not make that movie bad. Aliens made that movie bad.
Aliens made that movie bad, yeah. Let's be serious.
Where am I? This is I need to get to the artifact temple. Okay. All right, I'm in Tallon Overworld right now, aren't I?
Correct me if I'm wrong, Mom.
You're wrong.
Oh, I see.
Oh, wait, sorry, correct you. Well, I'll just tell you you're wrong.
There are no Nintendo games with quick travel, are there?
Doesn't Zelda Skyward Sword have some quick travel on it?
No quick travel in Skyward Sword. Or, I don't believe there is.
Actually,
no, it's just that you can choose your landing zone.
Yeah, that's right. So I suppose, sort of?
It's like semi-quick.
Semi-quick travel.
There are not, SGM, in Metroid Prime 1, there are only 250 missiles. It is Prime 2 and 3, I believe, that both have 255. The reason for the difference is there's the exact same number of missile expansions, the same missile launcher, but the difference is in both of those games there is the Seeker missile as well. And I believe the Seeker missile also acts as a missile expansion. We're only going to save twice more in this game.
Really?
Yep.
Are you like endgame right now?
Once before Ridley and once before Prime.
you just keep...
Way to fucking spoil it, God damn, I don't... To be honest, the only, like, end... Like, I've seen the Metroid Prime fight. I had no idea there was a Ridley fight before the Metroid Prime fight.
Oh, did you?
Oh, well, I suppose that's out the fucking window.
That's out of fucking bag. Fucking guys. Fucking...
I was yes, Majora's Mask has quick travel.
Oh, yeah, because you have the... Yeah,
it's true. It's very good, sir. Very good. And Xenoblade apparently has quick travel as well.
Yeah, that's not a direct Nintendo game, though. It's made of Monolith Soft, which is, at this point, basically a Nintendo developer, but...
Oh, is it third party?
It's like a... It's a studio that works pretty much exclusively with Nintendo now. So, I mean, I'm not sure if second party is a real term or not, but it's kind of like second party.
Okay, yeah, totally.
If that, like, I'm sure I'm not using that term correctly.
That should be a real term, though, yeah. Because, straight up, it's just like,
I think it's just a different branch of first party at this point.
It's the secondary developer, so it should be second party.
I don't think that's how that works, but okay. I mean...
It's not a specific... It's like, for instance, all the money being paid is not coming from Nintendo. They're developing it with a promise from Nintendo. Like, the guys who are doing that do not have their checks signed by Nintendo. However, at the same time, they probably also have a contractual guarantee.
So, Mump, you're... How many minutes would you say you are away from fighting Ridley?
I'm not going to answer that question.
Okay, let's get a Ridley hype. Because, I mean, soon, I think.
I'm really glad that Samus's I'm really glad that Samus's shoulders aren't disappearing this time around.
7 minutes.
Last time when I was at this point in the game on this emulator, when I got the Phazon suit, when I went to the ship, Samus's shoulders were like transparent. Her big shoulder pads like didn't show up properly.
You were back to like the basic suit?
No. It was the Phazon suit and everything. It was just a graphics glitch.
Oh.
Anyway, I said I don't know if the person's still here or not, but there is in theory still possibly a way to get to do the space jump boots jump early. You lock on to this guy. And then you hold this lock as you travel back to your ship, and then you do the crazy dash jump off of it like that. I'm not going to do it because I'm not going to walk all the way back, and I have doubts whether it even works in the trilogy version or not, but it is something you can do at least in newer versions of the GameCube Prime
let's just beat the fucking game. How about that?
Here's the longest load in the entire game is coming up. Oh, yeah, because I haven't been here yet.
Impact. Oh, really? Fuck, eh?
No, I have all the missiles. I'm good. Crimson, I'm good. I'm good. We're good. We're all good. The reason I don't have 100% complete is I'm still missing an artifact. Also, the entire incentive run for 100% was a scam.
Yeah.
We were doing 100% the entire time.
Yeah.
So, congratulations, everybody.
Yeah. That's called fraud.
Is it, though?
But we did it. We actually didn't do it. But whatever. We had fun. We got all the expansions. This door is... I'd just like to point out that I'm running this game on a super powerful PC with an SSD loading the game, and that door still took that long. I mean, at some point, the emulator is actually going to be limited in how fast it can go just by the fact that it has to emulate a GameCube, but... Or a Wii in this case, but, you know. My controller's still going strong, huh? We should, hold on, let's just... I wouldn't call it strong. Let's see if we can luck out and make it all the way to the end of the game.
Apparently you might have missed the Parasite Queen scan.
I was not going for 100% scans. At no point was I ever trying to do that. I was scanning things out of, like, instinct or...
Oh, how'd you get the last artifact?
It was right here.
Yeah, it's at this site.
Oh, fuck.
100% of all pickups.
Ba-boom.
And 61% of scans, while not even really trying to do it. Yeah, this fight... This fight might still stutter a bit.
So is this cinematic only cut when you get all...
Yeah, once you have all the artifacts. Because slowly, over time, if you come back here, those little heads light up with each of the artifacts. But since you returned with all of them...
I don't think I've actually seen the cinematic. I mean, I've seen the endgame fight. I don't think I've seen how you get there. Or I certainly haven't seen the Ridley fight, so...
Okay, so like I said, the Ridley fight might have some really crazy bad slowdown in it. I have a potential solution to it, if it happens.
Okay.
If the solution doesn't work, we'll still get through this fight. It's not the worst.
I have a question for you, Mom. What the fuck is Ridley doing here anyway? Like, why are you chasing him? Why are you...
He's the leader of the space pirates.
Sure, but
apparently, if this game takes as close, you know, after the original Metroid as possible, then she's chasing him down because he escaped from...
Yeah, he's the successor to Mother Brain, right?
I never thought of Mother Brain as, like, in charge
itself. The actual leader?
Yeah, or I thought of it as a computer that has sentience or whatever.
Yeah, and but has, isn't like, necessarily all the data management and
like,
stuff.
Like, it doesn't necessarily, like, it's not the highest ranking, it just makes all the decisions.
Yeah, it's the crux to shutting down their operation on Zeebs.
Yeah, so it's stuttering a lot. Let me just try to do the thing to make it better, and if it doesn't make it better, then we'll just deal with it.
Okay. And what is the thing to make it better?
It makes the scan visor break. But yeah, all of a sudden it's gone.
Oh, nice.
So, but we can't scan Ridley now.
Oh, whatever.
Oh, okay, or we can. Okay, it's supposed to cause it to break. Whatever.
Sweet.
I'm not gonna complain.
Okay.
Right, we got a full speed Ridley fight and scan? Oh, I think, hold on. The other visors maybe break? No, nothing's broken. Weird.
Why doesn't Ridley show up on X-ray?
That's a really good question.
Oh,
that's a
fucking excellent question. It could be because it's broken.
Like, yeah, okay.
Never. Also, the X-ray range has really bad range.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to see if he actually does show up or not. I guess we'll wait until he's actually on land.
So, what does Ridley want?
Yeah, no, he doesn't show. Oh, no, he was there.
What does Ridley want with the artifact anyway?
Or maybe he's not there. I don't know. You're not supposed to use the X-ray visor in this fight. He's trying to get access to the temple too, but I guess he's...
Why? Well, like, what's he...
They want Metroid Prime.
For what purpose?
To study it, to turn it into a weapon.
Okay. So Metroid Prime is a completely, like, unique species or, like...
Honestly, at this point in the story, you only have some guesses of exactly what Metroid Prime is based on the log entries that you've been reading.
From the Chozo Ruin, or Chozo...
And also, yeah, okay. What Metroid Prime is defined to be at the end of this game versus what he's defined to be at the end of Corruption, Metroid Prime 3.
Yeah.
Is debatably vastly different.
Okay.
They retcon stuff is what I'm going for. Also, you could originally just boost ball into him right now and immediately knock him into Phase 2. They got rid of that in this version. So yeah, I would if this were the GameCube version, I would already be fighting him in his Phase 2 form. Also, they gave him like foot stompy, like he didn't have those like foot stomp animations on him before. By the way, welcome to what I actually consider to be the hardest fight in the game, in the late game at least.
So Metroid Prime's first appearance in the entire series of Metroid. Is this game?
Yeah.
Okay.
But, yeah. Metroids have existed before, but not Metroid Prime.
Yeah, okay.
That was a cool little reflection. Hey, what's up, Ridley? Nice.
Can you Ghostbuster this motherfucker?
I was thinking about it, actually.
You should give her a go, bud. I feel like Ridley
running
is like,
out of missiles, though, would be horrifying in this fight.
For the Prime fight or for this fight?
No, for this fight.
Okay. Like, can you go back and save after this fight?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And the fight still, like, it won't trigger when you come back?
Nope.
Oh, nice.
But yeah, you want to go back to your ship because it'll replenish your missiles and stuff.
I'm not going to. There's not time for that.
Oh. You're not going to go back to your ship?
No.
Okay.
Wow, it's doing, like, no damage.
Yeah, it is, like, no damage.
It's fun, though.
Indeed.
Brutal.
I mean... Plasma shots to the chest do some pretty decent damage. But, I mean, it's super missiles. Super missiles are really the like, oh, you gotta kill something big real fast, huh?
The end all be all?
That's not gonna hit him. We got some dope Ridley fight music, though. He's really just destroyed this entire place. I just like he really looks like he gets hit by that.
Yeah, the animations really are pretty well done. So this is third form?
Second phase. This is if I had just hit him, like when he landed the first time, if I had just hit him with a boost ball in the original version of the game, it would have just immediately gone to this.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Glitch or just
it's a glitch, yeah.
Okay, okay. So now he's lost his ability to fly, obviously.
Yep, this is an hour ground battle. Okay. It's way more dangerous. Okay, so the I have a really bad habit of getting hit by his tail on his backswing. Because I always get cocky and forget
when,
about
when
it.
When he turned around?
Yeah.
Okay.
This is why running out of missiles sucks, because I found one strategy is to just spam missiles on him. Single missiles. Try and find the opening. Because you get a couple openings when he does that attack, whereas when he does the other attack, you get...
Fuck. You still have so much health.
Who do I do?
Yeah.
I'm actually doing way better this fight. I did really shitty last time.
Yeah.
That was pretty bad, but I just went for the... Oh, jeez.
Oh, yeah. That's some damage right there.
There's some... Oh, there's the tail swing.
Is that doing damage when you're hitting those?
No. Oh, I should have just kept fire. Oh, I'm down to 86 missiles.
Yeah, you're
yeah, but so is he.
Nice. Mash.
Not too slow.
So you're doing like a glitch to fire missiles faster, right?
Half glitch, half like, oh, it's just a trick you can do. Like, they had every chance to fix it.
Yeah, it's kind of like BXB for Halo 2 kind of thing. So how exactly does the firing missiles faster?
I'm just basically tapping both down on the D-pad to fire a missile and A to fire my shot at like the same time or just right after each other. So it keeps like toggling.
Oh, so it wants to go back into the mode where it shoots the pulse.
But yeah. Did none of those hit?
I'm not sure.
Pretty sure none of them hit.
What exactly is this the thing on his chest, the weak point?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm really trying to get that charge shot in on him there. It's hard though. Okay. What? Am I not doing any damage anymore?
I was gonna say, it doesn't seem like you're doing any damage, man.
That's weird. I'll try something other than missiles. Did that hit him? No. Go some liquid hot plasma.
Plasma. Okay, that's doing damage.
Yeah.
That's certainly doing damage.
I think I was off target.
Stay on target. Monk, you've turned off your onboard targeting computer. Is everything okay?
I'm fine.
I'm fine.
Okay, I'm just gonna spam missiles when he does that and not use them when he's actually vulnerable.
Star Wars hype? Yeah, you got that Star Wars hype. Yeah, you got that.
That's really weird. I'm not doing any damage.
Yeah, I saw that.
Do you think it's glitching based on that change I made? I'm just gonna unmake that change now that we're out of the flying phase. Oops, that's the wrong thing. that's the bumper. Anyone remember the bumper?
Whoops.
Yes, I'm aware that just corrupted the map.
Whoa.
Alright. With some luck, that was just a glitch caused by... Oh yeah, it's starting to stutter again. Whatever. We're almost done.
Yeah, that's doing good damage. Why are you shooting him in the head if it's his chest that's a weak point?
Because he's to make him do that.
Daggers.
Yep.
Oh, one more charge shot.
Yep. I agree. Oh man, three hits. Oh, you can just fire normal shots at him if he's doing that. Jeez, calm down. Oh, I missed. I missed! Oh, and he's got a little white thing on there that's a graphics glitch for sure. I wonder if that's... I wonder if I hit that... If I'm aiming at the graphics glitch, it causes a problem. Man, I'm almost dead, actually, huh?
What do you mean you're almost dead? You have like 500...
I mean, relative to how much health I started with.
Okay, sure. You're under 50%.
Well under.
Probably like approaching 25%.
It's because I'm going for those shots on when he does that, which I really shouldn't be going for.
Yeah, that does a lot of damage. There you go.
Oh, is my mouse? Has my mouse cursor? My mouse has been. My mouse cursor was there the whole time. Ah! You guys, you didn't see it either, huh?
No, we didn't see it. Oh, the Chozo.
Yeah, the Chozo get their revenge. See ya. They're like, hey, you blow up our temple. That's fucking not cool,
bro.
Yeah, they definitely threw the bro in at the end.
And these Chozo ghosts are not hostile?
These ones are not. For a change.
It actually goes into depth in some of the logs and explains what's happened. The problem is that...
That these Chozo ghosts are not suffering from mental illnesses.
Exactly.
Oh, it's clearly. Exactly.
So, yeah, the Chozo ghosts are very mentally ill in this game.
To help the other Chozos, you might want to donate to a certain society that provides support empowering to experience mental
mind
health
of the UK is specifically mandated with assisting those mental illness, particularly the Chozo ghosts of Tallon IV.
We campaign to improve services, raise awareness, and promote understanding.
By the way, welcome to the Impact Crater.
So, are you back to full missiles?
Welcome to my underground lair.
No, I have 33 missiles.
Laser. With freaking laser
with
beams.
The laser.
Okay. Mump, you gonna be good to do this fight with 33 missiles?
33 missiles.
Oh no, I'll be totally fucked with 33.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yep.
Let's see this shit.
So this is the one of the scariest rooms in the game. If you don't know what, if you haven't developed a strategy. I have a strategy that seems to work about 80-90% of the time.
Those look like teeth.
They certainly do, don't they?
Yeah. I continue with your strategy?
I'm doing it, which is don't stop for nothing.
Don't stop for nothing.
Pretty much. Those things will fucking come after you and they spawn.
Yeah, they're fish and Metroids.
They just fucking spawn.
Wait, what are you going on about? I don't see anything chasing me.
Fish and Metroids spawn in the bottom of this room.
I'm actually getting surprisingly lucky.
Yeah.
This is the
final missile recharge room of the game.
Oh, nice.
Ah, right.
Oh, perfect, yes. So.
Who knows why it's in the Impact Crater? I mean, from a like design point of view, not from a it's a game point of view. All right, so now part two of the strategy, which I feel really confident about. It really depends on... Yes, okay, good. I need both of these guys' attention. This is Mump Strat here. Mump Strat. Where's the other one? Good, I got him. Okay, so it takes a little while for them to respawn. So I use this opportunity after killing both of them simultaneously with the same power bomb to dash for the rest of it. And we're through. Again, we have this. We could, like, this is red phase on in here, which totally does exist, by the way. It still hurts me, even though I have phase on suit protection or whatever. So you're supposed to do this morph ball thing, but I mean, like, it's so small, like, you probably could just jump. And we have arrived.
Metroid Prime.
Any final donations? Striker?
I don't know. Striker's not here right now.
Oh, what? He left for the final boss?
Yes, he's never coming back.
Man. That guy sucks. He just misses out on all the stuff. Oh, I mean, like, he's like, ah, I've seen that fight before. It's Ridley I cared about.
Yeah, this guy's been asleep for, like, 200 years.
Metroid Prime?
Yeah.
Well, according to the pirate logs, they've been, like, poking and prodding in some way, shapes, or forms. He's got a face.
Metroid
that's really weird.
Metroid Prime. Highly evolved.
The face is really...
producing.
Kind of creepy.
Yep.
So he's, like, basically an advanced version of the space pirates, which, again, it says, basically, that Metroid Prime stole this technology from the space pirates. But again, that doesn't make any sense, because he's been in his impact crater this entire time. Wow!
What do you mean Metroid Prime stole it from the space pirates?
Some of the logs say that they had captured Metroid Prime and that he escaped and stole some of their technology, which is why he has this exoskeleton and all this armor plating and stuff.
Huh.
But then that's kind of contradictory to what happens in 3, where you see like multiple Metroid Prime kind of husks in other places. So perhaps the spider thing is Metroid Prime, but then the elemental shielding is what he stole. But then again, no one should have been able to get access to the impact crater. So,
not to mention the beam weapons.
All I know is you gotta fucking Ghostbuster this motherfucker.
You just did.
Yeah, I did.
You just missed him Ghostbusting the motherfucker.
Ice is the best, fire is the worst.
Ghost ride, get out the way, let Swayze drive.
Let Casper drive.
Let Casper drive.
Ghost drive, go crazy. Who's that driving, Patrick Swayze?
So, as many times as I've beaten Metroid Prime, I've played this boss fight probably 100 times in the past. I just would redo Ridley and this guy like over and over again. And I should have found another ice spreader there. I was zoning out talking about stuff. That's why ice is best, so because you can get two phases in one.
Ghostbuster!
I like this one best because the damage is the most obvious.
Uses up a lot of missiles.
Yes, that is true though.
Darkness. So he's just burrowing farther in the impact crater?
Yep.
To what end?
I don't know. I can't remember how you're supposed to escape this.
Doesn't actually do any damage.
Yeah, he's not doing any damage.
Well, if he pulls you close enough, he does. Maybe you're supposed to shoot him or something.
It's a tractor beam.
Yeah, it's a tractor beam.
Ah.
Sorry, I should have made that more clear.
WorldGone sitting there like, dude, he's doing no damage, bro.
Sure, like, what? is he inviting you over for a hug and a kiss? Or?
Casserole, I think.
Prime rib, lol.
You think I can get another super in there?
Sure, bud.
Yeah.
Can you do any, like, crazy morph ball tactics?
Hold on, I need to take these balls out first. I should just use missiles. My ice beam's too slow. Oh god, I'm gonna get hit by that. No!
Use the force, Luke!
I got it.
Always.
The ice beam doesn't do much damage. Those balls actually do a decent amount of damage, though. Yeah, no, ice spreader's the best. And if I do this right, I should be able to hit him again. And that cancels that phase. He went to plasma, but I canceled it. And like I said, plasma's the worst one, so that's nice.
So it certainly seems like if you know what you're doing with the ice beam, it's OP.
Oh yeah, ice beam's pretty OP. Okay, that was certainly using up a lot. Alright, I believe this is final phase.
See, I think I've seen World do this fight twice and Mempf do it once.
Oh, he starts up. Oh, this is where he starts to change like a motherfucker, right?
Yeah, he starts to do that, yeah. I'm not gonna wave bust him.
Wave bust him.
Yeah, good choice.
He changes too often now. And I'm low on missiles. I'd rather get ice spreaders and super missiles. I can't walk on while he's got me doing that. Or while he's got me all staticky.
Someone's asking you to throw off the flamethrower if you can.
To show it off if I can?
If you can.
I mean, I can't. did he just go into fire? Ah, he just switched. He just switched again.
Oh my god.
I don't think I'm going to. I'll show it off if I make it to the next fight and have missiles left.
Yeah, if you can.
Yeah, because then missiles are useless at that point. You're doing really good on health, though, man, so...
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God, yeah. I'm not going to die on Metroid Prime. I might die on Ridley, but Metroid Prime, no. Let's see if I can... Flamethrower! Oh, okay, that was... No, okay, that I'm was... Good, that's thanks. The that's the best flamethrower you're going to get. Should be able to get another plasma in. Nope. Okay. Wave's good though because it like auto homes in on him real easy.
Mm-hmm.
All right, people, come on, let's be serious here. Let's get some fucking donations in.
Watching him kick these guys' ass here, no problem, eh?
And watching him kick fucking Buddy in the teeth, and he's just bringing him fucking down. We've kept our fucking stick on the ice for 8 hours now.
I'm actually really curious to see the final time.
Yeah, okay.
If it's over 8 hours, I will have failed. If it's under 7, I will be super psyched.
I think it's over 8 right now.
In-game timer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Because we're getting kind of close to our maximum amount of time.
It's okay. We're gonna scan Metroid Prime here. There's something about Metroid Prime that makes me think that in Truist, he might be an X-Virus.
Yeah, this guy's fucking dope.
He looks like he seems
Prime,
like X-Virus.
And it's like he looks so cool, man.
Alright, let's get some fucking final round hype going on, eh? Worlds, give me a fucking cheers here, bud.
So I'm just gonna stand on this wood here.
You got something.
Yeah, you got a fucking beer in your hand, bud.
Fucking guy.
Yeah, you got a fucking beer in your hand. Take some of those fucking pig stinks if you want them.
Pig stinks.
Alright, so he leaves his pure Phazon pools around.
Yep.
And he switches into different modes. And I go to hyper mode. Right. And I'm pretty sure if I just start...
This is the birth of hyper mode.
Pretty sure I heard that if you just like keep toggling it, like if you just don't like spam it, it lasts longer and does more damage. But I don't think that's actually true. So that did very little damage.
Well, it looked like you were stalling them for quite a bit.
Yeah, no, the only way you can do damage to him in this fight is through the Phazon beam. Alright, where's that fucking cheers at, you fucking
hoser?
Oh, my
fucking Metroid hype.
Fucking hoser, eh?
Cheers,
bud. Look at this fucking guy. He just chooses to spawn the goddamn Phazon, wherever the fuck he feels like. He's just like, oh, I'm just gonna take a piss right here, eh?
And Samus is like, oh, don't you fucking piss in my cup and tell me it's apple
juice. Yeah, then he just goes and sprays his piss right back in his face.
Fucking
silver showers going on over here.
Thanks, XXX0. The trick is apparently is to enter and re-enter the pool, not to toggle your fire. I knew there's a trick. I've never pulled it off because I like this. I normally like this fight too much, so I try and like I don't try and make it go as quick as possible.
What's the trick designed to do?
Did you scan him?
Yes.
Nice.
Yeah, I did. But I'm missing scans, man.
What's the trick designed to do?
Make the pool Phazon last longer. I don't know if I'm doing it right. I don't think I'm actually like leaving the puddle. Whatever. I'm just gonna take him down the way I know.
You mean the way that's prescribed in the Prima Official Guide?
Maybe.
It's in the.
Wait, what am I doing?
Space Pirate Handbook.
I should be using. There's only one beam you should be using in this fight. And that's the ice beam.
Yeah.
Hey, HPAW crew, did you ever beat this game on hard mode?
The hyper mode difficulty? Yeah, I've done that once.
Nope.
It's trickier. But I mean, if you get one for 100%, like, it doesn't really matter.
So what's the difficulty mean in this game? Is it just like damage or is it like AI improvement?
Raw damage.
Okay.
What? Sorry, where is... Ah! How did you survive? I fucking used a power bomb on you.
Okay, yeah, you're giving him the fucking Jimmy, yeah?
Giving him no hot fire there.
Giving him no hot fire, bud.
But the fact that Metroid Prime can spawn Metroid makes me think he actually probably is a Metroid.
Yeah.
Also, I always consider Metroid Prime a guy, but you know, once it's Metroid, once there's Dark Samus, like, I don't know.
No, yeah, totally. I always felt it was a masculine personality as well.
Really?
It would have to be.
Go on.
Okay.
Well, you gotta go on.
Okay, well, I'll elaborate because it shows instead of immediately doing whatever it took to protect its shit, it decided that it would be smarter to lay in wait and see how it could possibly use these new life forms that sought to abuse it, hence taking their technology and shit, rather than simply being blinded by its need to protect its domain, which is more feminine, or protect its young, or offspring, or whatever. Yeah, it shows logic and sacrifice of its young, which were being executed and experimented on, in order for its own benefit, which is distinctly masculine.
And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Women are not logic.
The what logic?
The women are not logical.
The women are not
logical. Straight from the world's mouth.
I'm just saying the priorities are different.
I like how he just gets in your face like that. He just totally gets in your face.
Oh, boy.
Also, Metroids die immediately from hyper beam shots.
Yeah. Crimson Dragon, it is indeed. It's pretty sexist.
The what now?
The what now? So how many fucking... Mom, I was talking about that I would donate for every countdown timer you came across. So
there were none.
Yeah.
See, other than that first one.
I think it'll probably be one at the end of this game. Hopefully.
Things do tend to blow up at the end of when Samus is done.
I certainly intend to donate more than fucking $4.30.
You might have to come back for another Metroid Prime Marathon then.
Well, I mean, a bit of a half one.
I got good news for you, though. Hey, look, it's a fusion or fission. Well, what visor is he in now? X-ray? Nope. Thermal? Yep.
How could you be in thermal but not be in X-ray?
Because he can change the spectrum.
The frequency that he's blocking out. X-ray is way higher frequency than thermal. Thermal's actually quite low.
Yeah, thermal's below the visual spectrum, right?
Yeah. So it's the opposite ends of the spectrum.
Now here's the question, is thermal above or below infrared?
It's
thermal is infrared.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
They shouldn't be.
This is infrared.
Well, I have just one question. How come you can have thermal goggles with the difference in the colors, but then you can have infrared and it just comes off as white?
That's false color.
Hey, guess what?
Explain.
Let's not explain. Let's just watch Metroid Prime die. Because he's pissed off right now.
Wait, is that time?
Because I know for a fact that there is a difference in military doctrine between infrared and thermal vision.
I'm sure there is.
Sure, maybe in terms of like the quality of the image, but
so I always thought that one
in terms of like the spectrum.
Once he pulled off the, I always thought that this had turned into a cutscene after that because it always looked higher quality once the Phazon had been ripped out of your suit. But having now watched this on an emulator, nah. Nah, it's just that's all real time rendered.
Crater collapse imminent. Evacuate immediately. Insects of dark.
Do 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 do. No, we're not gonna.
Not go there. Yay! Can we get a beat the game hype?
Ship, get the fuck over here.
We did it.
Yeah. 100% hype? Yeah? Hype? World, give me a hype. Give me a hype.
No, there ain't no hype to be had.
Wait, oh geez, that really, oh geez. Microphones. We can do that further away with the microphones.
Yeah.
Oh god.
Yeah. Oh, so much for your chosen.
Way to just destroy all those priceless artifacts, Samus. Fuck.
Ridley destroyed them?
So much for, yeah, that a likely fucking story. Ridley destroyed, that's what went in a report.
Look, I took off my helmet, okay?
This game is representative of compiled reports. This isn't what really fucking happened.
She's thinking to herself, how am I going to cover this in the Federation report?
How the fuck am I going to cover this one up? After she fucked that up, she's just like, fuck. And she's like, yeah, Ridley. Ridley was there in the space part. We found no evidence of this. Well, you know, they're pretty fucking good with that shit.
And yes, Axel, Metroid is a girl.
How is Metroid a girl? Metroid Prime?
No, Metroid, the protagonist of the game. That was the joke.
I see.
Very well, sir. So... yeah, I mean, we'd like to thank Ben Sprout.
We'd like to thank the animation lead, Vince Jolie. Yeah, wow, we were both thinking that. Yeah, I mean, like, obviously we need to thank him.
And Todd Keller and Mark Pacini.
Pacini.
And a very, very special thanks to Satoru Iwata. Rest in peace.
Yes, buddy.
Rest in peace.
Creator of Metroid, right?
No, he's the president and CEO of Nintendo until...
He died?
Yeah, he passed away.
Oh, I think he did.
When?
A month or two ago.
Oh, a month or two ago, man. Dude, it was like Christopher Lee, man. Christopher Lee died in June.
Hey, look! Reggie Fils-Aimé is in the special thanks as
really?
Well.
Oh, nice.
Oh, shit.
Fils-Aimé. Christopher Lee, if anybody doesn't know, he played Count Dooku.
Most of us know who Christopher
And also,
Lee is.
What's his name?
Saruman.
No.
But also Saruman.
Fuck, what's the guy from Man with the Golden Gun?
He did play Scaramanga.
Scaramanga, that's what
he did play Scaramanga.
Yeah,
wow, good call, man. Good call.
Yeah. Yeah, Mom watched it. Okay, so that remember when Blood and I came
up
with that?
Yeah, I know.
That was Christopher Lee.
That was Christopher Lee?
Hell yeah.
The villain?
Scaramanga,
yep.
Serious? Holy shit, it was.
I totally spaced on that myself. Yeah. It's like, wow, dude. Fuck, man. Dude, he was in World War II, eh? He was a fighter pilot.
Was he?
Yeah, Royal Air Force.
Fuck, eh?
He was in the Battle of fucking Monte Cassino,
And
dude.
A very special thanks to producer Shigeru Miyamoto.
Shigeru Miyamoto.
And Kenji Yamamoto for the music.
Hideaki Shimizu.
And the Super Mario Club!
Yeah.
And Xehanort! Yeah! Darkness above all else! Nothingness is eternal!
Indeed.
All right, yeah.
Kingdom Hearts.
Kingdom Hearts.
You do that pretty good.
Yeah, World is pretty good.
I just realized, people who play Ansem keep dying. Christopher Lee played Ansem the Wise.
Oh yeah, Chris. Fuck, man! That's so true, yeah, Ansem, fuck.
And another form of Xehanort was played by Leonard Nimoy.
Wow, brutal.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Brutal.
Two for two.
Yeah, yeah.
All right,
games, scenario, music, and program is by Nintendo.
Don't claim this video, Nintendo, on YouTube. Hey, look, the video's not broken this time.
So is this the 100% thing?
Well, this is the video that I said was really
no,
broken.
No, the 100% was seeing her face, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, no, you need 75% item completion.
Oh,
for that.
75 or more.
So where's the 100% bullshit?
Here it is. No, after this. It's after this.
She's gonna get...
625!
Wow, nice.
Wow.
Woo!
Good.
Yes. I'm giving
And then it crashed.
It just crashed.
It crashed
before our special scene.
No way.
It totally did.
Oh my god.
Oh no, we're good. It recovered.
Non-crash hype.
It recovered from the crash.
Oh, 625 non-crash hype. Give me cheers.
Let's get out of this menu before it does crash though. Let's get out of this menu.
Here we go. This is 100%. Samus should have had black hair.
and then they redesigned him.
This reminds me of Majora's Mask. The whole eye thing. I don't know why.
Yeah. Just gonna save now. We'll finish this game.
Perfect. We're like perfectly on schedule, month.
Was it 8:30?
8:30 Pacific Standard Time.
Oh, exactly.
Is when Johnny is supposed to start doing some crazy shit. I think with Castlevania, if I'm not mistaken.
Castlevania.
All right, so then I guess we'll just wrap up here. Any final donations come in the very last minute?
Let me check.
You have 1 minute to donate.
And we'll see you all. Well, I don't know about all of us here, but I'll at least be back for Metroid Prime 2. Echoes. I'm not exactly sure what day that's happening. I think that's the 18th. So 9 days from now.
The Monday.
I think it's a Tuesday.
Okay.
So yeah, we'll be running Prime 2. That will be way less pro. Like, I'd know that game way less. It'll be way, way more interesting. Why was HPAW emulating the game? Because the game looks fantastic when it's rendered at 1080p. I'm gonna release an HD archive of all of this stuff. It's gonna be in 1080p, even though it doesn't necessarily need to be, but it'll look amazing. It'll be available on YouTube and on the HPAW website for direct download in its full amazing quality. So check out hpaw.net. For the archive versions, I'll maybe have Tom link them or whatever. And we'll see. And what about Prime 3? Well, hey, who knows? We might need an incentive.
Fuck you, Palm Freeze. I mean, Prime 3.
I mean, we have a schedule here, so I don't know if we can fit in another game into the whole thing, but who knows? Maybe I'll run it on my channel.
So,
yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
This is Prime 2?
This is Prime 2. This is a little preview of Prime 2, and that's Prime 3.
That's Prime 3. That's like right near the beginning.
Okay.
That's actually pretty far in. You got ship missiles already. Like, you don't get ship missiles until a while.
You see, it pissed me off with the ship missiles that you never got to use them in fucking combat.
Oh, that's not true.
Was it just boss battles?
There are very specific rooms that are, outdoor and open that you can call your ship in. It's just, you can't call your ship in and destroy a room.
Well, yeah, when you're in a room.
But the outdoor rooms, like, most of the outdoor rooms, there's just not a lot of them. Anyway, thank you very much for watching, everybody. And we'll see you, well, again, like I said, I'll see you for Metroid Prime 2, and enjoy the rest of the Nintendothon until we get there.